first of all, I would like to ask you, how does it feel to be, you know, nominated by Prime Minister of India for the fitness challenge?
Yes,
please tell us about that.
I was amazed when they told me that I am selected. But it's amazing that Prime Minister, he nominated me, and I feel very proud. And I think I am sure that I will do more hard work after that to retain my
retain your spot there.
Yes.
correct. So, what are your plans for Asian Games? As in, how many medals are you targeting this time?
I will not say about medals, but. Like I played in Commonwealth Games, I will play 100% over there, and I will give my best.
So all of us at KreedOn always have this question, where could Manika go in her career? I mean, what is your dream, ultimate dream, what is your goal?
Ultimate dream is obviously Olympic medal.
Yeah.
And short term goal, I have to be in top 40. I want to be in top 40 in world rankings. So that's my goal.
Okay.
And
great.
Defeat some Chinese or Japanese.
Awesome. So to break into the top 100 of India, I mean top 100 of the world, I mean, how does it feel? Because you were the first one to do it, right? So
I felt amazing when last ranking was 40 in some 40. So at that time I was feeling very proud of myself that abroad, foreigners, they think that Indians cannot do better or something, but I had to prove everyone, and that's why I think
can win it here, you can win it
yes
everywhere.
Like I said. Yes,
being an engineer, obviously you're an inspiration for all the engineers in
I
India,
I don't right? suggest anyone to take up engineering if you want a professional career,
right? Absolutely. So last time you were unbeaten, and what are your expectations in this UTT, this season?
Yes, of course, to be unbeaten again, I mean, it can't get that better, but I think I mean good run, and playing this is so much fun along with the team energy, I think I like playing team matches when there is so much energy on the bench,
right?
And this is helping me a lot. The team has been very supportive.
All right.
So I hope I continue this run, and I take this is going to be very tough this year. They are more better players, top 20. So if I happen to beat unbeaten this year, I think this is going to be fantastic.
So what do you think, how much UTT affected the overall level of table tennis in India?
I mean, you could see that on the table, I think. So that really speaks, because we have done very well in the Commonwealth Games, and I was 120 last year in UTT, and coming now as 44.
Yeah.
So I think that's a huge jump in the world rankings. It all started probably in the last year's UTT. That gave me that confidence, go out and play, and that belief that if I can beat them here, then I can beat them in the world circuits as well. So that really helped, and I think that stepped it up there. And not just me, Kamal, who's been always there, and Manika, and the entire Indian team level has really gone up.
Yeah.
And now it's everyone is expecting Indians to win against even the top 20. I think that itself speaks for what level we have raised up here.
So, can we expect a better performance from Commonwealth in Asian Games?
We already did wonderful in Commonwealth, winning 8 medals. I think it was fantastic. Yeah, Asian Games is going to be a different ball game, of course, with top level players China, Japan. So, we're going to give their best with the confidence. I think Indian players are playing very well.
Yeah.
And probably if we have a good draw, then there is a chance to win a medal in the team events. And we're just looking forward to play and have fun like we did in the Commonwealth.
Okay. I think that they will pick up the sport and take it
on. So, it's a good preparatory event for the upcoming Asian Games.
Because for the Asian Games we'll need to be very sharp and very fit. So I think these kind of matches help us get there and do that.
Correct.
And also it gives us the confidence when we are up against the same players.
All right.